मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रदीप हीरापुरे एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, प्लाज्मिड नथिंग बट द एक्स्ट्रा क्रोमोसोमल मटेरियल प्रेजेंट इन द बैक्टीरियल सेल. एंड इन 1960 जैकोब सेप्री एंड वोलमन कॉल्ड इट इज इपिजोम. ओके, एंड द So in this way the plasmid can transfer from one generation to the another generation. Now we are going to discuss about the basic features of a plasmid DNA. So plasmid size vary from 1 to 1 kb nucleotide. Then they usually contain 5 to 100 genes and usually carry genes that are useful but not essential to survival. And the genes which make bacteria resistant to the antibiotics. So whatever the genes or whatever the sequence actually present in a plasmid, they are not responsible for the survival of bacteria. If the plasmid is removed from that bacterial cell, then that bacterial cell can grow on the nutrient medium and survive. So actually the plasmid not essential for the survivability of that bacterial cell. And as long as the bacterium is thriving in a low stress environment, so removing all the plasmid would not affect the ability of bacterium to survive. So whenever we provide the stress condition, that plasmid remain as it is inside the cytoplasm of bacterial cell. But in a low stress condition, low stress environment, sometime that plasmid can remove from the bacterial cell, and even that bacterial cell can grow on the nutrient medium. So specifically, plasmid are non-essential extrachromosomal piece of DNA. So that plasmid is a circular double-stranded in nature, as well as this plasmid carry the various types of genes, and it is responsible for the expression of particular specific characteristics in that bacteria, as well as this plasmid independently can replicate, not depends on the chromosomal DNA for the replication purpose. So these are the some basic characteristics or characteristics feature of the plasmid. Now you can see the diagrammatic representation or the genetic map of the bacterial plasmid. So you can see this is a double-stranded and circular DNA molecules, and in this DNA molecule you can see from this point to this point this sequence is responsible for the replication functions. Okay, so this is actually the ORI sequence, sorry, replication purpose, I mean bacterial replication. And then there is a IS1, MIR, SULS, STR, CAT. So these are the some restriction endonuclease sites. Okay, so there is a multiple cloning sites, and here is actually the ORI sequence, ORI, and this TRA sequence is there for the transfer of bacterial plasmid from one generation to the another generations. Okay, and there is a tetracycline, antibiotic resistant genes also there. So this is actually the basic typical structure of the plasmid DNA. Now basically the classification of plasmid carried out on the basis of transferability means the ability to transfer from its own cell to the another bacterial cell. So depending upon this this ability, the plasmid DNA classify into the two types, conjugative plasmid and non-conjugative plasmid. So conjugative plasmid means what? The plasmid DNA contain the transgenes, which is responsible for the transfer of copy of plasmid from one cell to the another cell. So the contain transgenes which perform the complex process of conjugation, bacterial conjugation, and the transfer of plasmid to another bacterium cell. For example, F plasmid, many R plasmids, and some Col plasmids also consider as a conjugative plasmid. Why? Because the plasmids transfer from parents to the daughter cells. Then there is a non-conjugative plasmids incapable of initiating conjugation, means there is a conjugations and there is a stop conjugation process, are incapable of the initiation conjugation. Hence they can be transferred only with the assistance of conjugative plasmid. Okay, so they are the negative plasmid. I think for example the many R plasmid and most Col plasmids, which are unable to transfer its own plasmid DNA from one cell to the another cell. And there is in some books actually the third types also is there, and that third type nothing but the mobilizable plasmid, means an intermediate class of the plasmid. They carry only a subset of the genes required for the transfer, and they can parasitize another plasmid and transfer at high frequency in the presence of conjugative plasmid. So this type of class or this type of plasmid is unable to transfer its plasmid without the presence of conjugative plasmid. But in presence of conjugative plasmid, this this bacteria can transfer its own plasmid to the other cell. So that known as a mobilizable plasmids. Now you can see here the sexual transfer of plasmid to another bacterium cell through the pilus. So yeah, you can see this one is the bacterial cell, this one is the chromosomal cell, and this one is the another bacterial cell without the plasmid, means plasmid deficient cell, we can say. So on the basis of plasmid presence or absence, the bacteria classify into the two cell are bacterial cell actually classify into two types. One is negative cell. This bacterial cell is act as a positive, and this one is negative, means because this is only having chromosomal DNA, but this cells having chromosomal DNA and the plasmid DNA also, and this positive cell or this bacterial cell able to synthesize the pilus, one tube like structure in between these two cells, and through that pilus the copy of plasmid DNA can transfer from this F positive cell to the F negative cell, and this based on the function of bacterial cell, the plasmid classify into the different types. First one is the degradative plasmid. Degradative plasmid means what? They are able to digest or degrade the unusual substances like toluene and salicylic acid. And apart from this, so many different types of harmful substances present in the environment may be degraded by using the bacteria due to the presence of specific plasmid, and that such type of plasmid known as a degradative plasmid. So for example, the toll plasmid is responsible to degrade the toluene, and second one is a virulence plasmid. So virulence nothing but the pathogenicity or the capacity or ability of infection. Okay, so the virulence plasmid contains a vir gene, and which turn the bacterium into the pathogens. For example, the TI plasmid or RI plasmid, which are present in the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Okay, and due to the presence of this TI or RI plasmid, that bacteria can infect to the plant cell and responsible to induce the tumor inside the plant cells, or induce the roots, hairy roots into the infected plant cells. So such type of plasmid known as a virulent plasmid. Okay. Then there is a third class, that is a fertile plasmid or fertility F plasmid. Okay. So this type of plasmid contains TRA genes, which is responsible for the transfer of plasmid from one place to one cell to the another cell, and they are capable of conjugation and result in the expression of sex pili, and for example F plasmid of E. coli cell. So you can see here, this one is the F positive cell, and this one is the F negative cell, means due to the absence of plasmid, this cell known as a negative cell, and due to the presence of genes is responsible for the pili synthesis, there is a pili formations occur, and due to the pili formation there is a channel formation, and through that channel the DNA, plasmid DNA can replicate itself and produce the copy of that, and that copy DNA transfer into the F negative cells, and in this way the plasmid copy of plasmid transfer from one cell to the another cell. So this is a mechanism of conjugation, and this type of plasmid known as a F plasmid or fertile plasmid. Now there is another class, that is a resistance plasmid. So this resistance plasmid contains genes that provide resistance against antibiotics and poisons, historically known as a R factor. And before the nature of plasmids was understood, so the due to the presence of specific genes, this bacteria can produce the resistance against various types of antibiotics like tetracycline, ampicillin. So if the ampicillin resistance gene is present on the plasmid, and that plasmid present inside the bacterial cell, so such type of bacteria can grow in presence of ampicillins also. So such type of plasmid known as a resistance plasmid. Okay, and one more class is there is a Col plasmid. So that Col plasmid containing the genes that code for the bacteriocin. So that bacteriocin is a toxic molecules produce and able to kill the other bacteria. Okay, so one bacteria having a Col plasmid, which is due to the presence of Col plasmid, that bacterial cell can produce the toxin and bacteriocins inside the cytoplasm, and then that bacteriocins and toxins molecules secrete inside the medium or outside the cells of that bacteria. And due to the production of this toxin material or toxin molecule, the other bacterial cell can kill around the Col plasmid containing bacteria. So for example, the plasmid name is Col E1. Now the plasmid based classify again into the different classes based on the copy number. Okay, actually the copy number means what inside the cell, how many copy of plasmid actually present. So it indicates the copy number of plasmid or copy numbers. So depending upon the copy number, plasmid classify into the stringent plasmid and relaxed plasmid. So what is actually the stringent plasmid? Stringent plasmid nothing but it replicates only along with the main bacterial chromosomes and is present as a single copy at most several copies per cell. So basically this one is the stringent plasmid, means slow replicating plasmid. And whenever the cell, parent cell divide and produce daughter cell, so the 1 to 2 times only replicate that plasmid DNA. And when we observe the bacterial cell, so there is a 1 or 2 plasmid molecules actually present. So such type of plasmid known as a stringent plasmid. But relaxed plasmid means what? So it is replicate within the cell independently of the chromosomal DNA replication, and this one is the fast replicating plasmid. And before the cell division, that plasmid itself replicate and produce the multiple copies. And whenever we observe the bacterial cell, so we found that inside the bacterial cell there is a multiple copies of plasmid, and such type of plasmid known as a relaxed plasmid. Okay. Now we're going to discuss about the application of plasmid in the field of research. So the plasmid, they are important tools in genetic engineering, and various genetics and biochemistry lab in which we perform the gene clonings and genetic engineering experiment, in which we routinely use the plasmid as a vector for carrying DNA. And we perform the cloning purpose, cloning experiments in the laboratory. And the plasmid also utilized for the multiply or expression of a particular gene. If you want to express the insulin coding gene in the laboratory or in the bioreactor for the expression of that insulin gene, and such type of recombinant genes also we can express with the help of plasmid inside the bacterial cell. This plasmid also utilized in the gene therapy to deliver the specific correct copy of gene inside the cell or target specific tissue. And plasmid also utilized in a molecular cloning process. Then plasmid which is used in genetic engineering are called as a vector. So these are the some applications of plasmid DNA. So we here stop this lecture.